on November 23rd at approximately at 15:30 p.m. writer and journalist Rafig Tagi died in the intensive care unit of the clinical center. A victim of an assassination attempt on November 19th, Tagi underwent a bit difficult surgery to repair the damage caused by 6 stab wounds, and his condition over the past few days was described by doctors as stable. After surgery on Saturday night, Rafig Tagi even gave a short interview to Objective. Yesterday morning, Tagi's condition deteriorated and he was returned to the intensive care unit. However, he passed away at approximately 15:30. I was talking with him. I spoke with him for an hour. I told Rafig that after leaving the hospital, you should go abroad. Your security will be guaranteed abroad. I told him that you are able to write your articles freely abroad. Did his condition instantly deteriorate? He said that he wants to vomit. Who was near him at the time? They were my nephew and police security personnel. Then I called for the nurses. They approached Rafig Tagi coldly. They paid no attention to him. It's the doctor's fault. I'm also partly to blame. I should have helped him when he was vomiting. I don't know. Maybe half of the blame is mine. A post-mortem is being conducted. The head of Union of Forensic and Medical Expertise and Pathological Anatomy, Shakir Musayev, said that the reason for publicist's death is a deterioration of a stab wound in the abdominal cavity. This is a serious issue. There was negligence in the case and the criminal case should be launched. I met with him when he was in the intensive care unit. He had a healthy look and was unconscious. He gave interviews to newspapers. And how did he die? What is the reason of his death? When he was transferred to the common ward, if his condition was so serious, should be investigated in a criminal case. He died unexpectedly in the common ward and there are serious facts pointing to negligence. It may be deliberate murder. That's why the case should be investigated. I met with Rafig several hours before his death. I can say that he felt very well. Of course, I don't know why he died. This is a controversial issue for a country who has proved itself as a secular state. I think that we should look for the reasons of his murder in his health. I believe that people cannot be prosecuted for their thought. People here can be murdered for their thoughts. I believe that Rafig Tagi has been murdered for his activities. The murderers didn't succeed in murdering him. However, it seems our health system did. And right now, I don't rule out that doctors deliberately showed negligence to Rafig Tagi. So investigations are being carried out into his cause of death. And when facts are revealed, it will be clear who wanted his death and that their wish came true. The fact is that Rafig Tagi didn't die from the stab wounds he received. As a result of stab wounds, doctors conducted the surgery and removed his spleen. The rest of his body organs had been functioning properly. He died as a result of the bad healthcare system. He may have been murdered because of his articles. He suggested this in his last speech. I talked with him in the hospital for several minutes to clear up the issue. He also believed that he may have been stabbed because of his articles. An investigation should be conducted. After the investigation, it will be clear that why he was murdered. Writer journalist Rafig Tagi was stabbed near his home as he was returning home from work. A criminal case has been launched against the unknown assailant for deliberately inflicting grave injury under the Article 126.1 of the Criminal Code. Nobody has been arrested for this crime. Rafig Tagi, a physician at Emergency Medical Aid Station No. 8, and his colleagues said that the reason for the attempt on his life was his last article, published on November 11th, entitled Iran and the Inevitability of Globalization. On November 15, 2006, Rafig Tagi was arrested for his article Europe and Us, originally published in Sanat newspaper. He was sentenced to 3 years in jail under the Article 283.1 of the Criminal Code, incitement of national, racial, and religious hatred. Rafig Tagi was the second writer to be murdered for his professional work in Azerbaijan. The first was Elmar Hussainov in 2005.